So up next, Harvey. And here it comes. And first offering is fouled off. Smith wheels and deals. And that one fouled off.
They need a strikeout, and you need a ball perhaps on the ground for a double play or get yourself a pop-up, something, but you've got to make some pitches. But if he can battle and get through this, he can earn some points.
Smith comes to the plate. Got him! Now a double play could get the Monarchs out of it. Now here is Marshall. First pitch just misses. Flips the corner and the count even at one. The next pitch misses, 2-1. On the ground, 2-2. They take the force out. Hilton needs just one more out to escape danger. Hilton Smith tightropes out of the bases loaded jam.
Hilton Smith earned a reputation as being Satchel's shadow, the legendary Satchel Paige. He would oftentimes come in and relieve Satchel. Well, Satchel was the draw. So Satchel's going to pitch 2 or 3 innings. And who came in and pitched the last 6 or 7? Hilton Smith. And all the old timers in the Negro League say, if you're going to get anything, you better get it off of Satchel, because you weren't going to touch Hilton Smith.
To the batter now, Terry. The pitch. It really does Hilton Smith the disservice to think of him only as Satchel Paige's shadow. But Smith always knew he was just as good on the mound, even if Satchel was the box office main attraction. Misses outside, and the count's even at 2.
Yeah, there are a lot of major leaguers who found out just how good Hilton Smith was, too. In 1937, he threw a shutout against a team with Bob Feller, Vince DiMaggio, and Johnny Mize as part of a barnstorming series. And in all 3 games he pitched, the White players didn't score a single run off him.
Now, Cole. And the first pitch misses for ball one.
Hilton was so good in interracial games over the years that Mize and Stan Musial both said he had as good a curveball as they'd ever seen. High praise coming from 2 Hall of Fame players.
Check swing went around. 2-2. Swings and misses on the fastball up in the zone for the strikeout. Here's the third baseman, Gordon. And first offering is fouled off.
After Hilton was done playing, he followed in his father's footsteps and became a school teacher in Kansas City. Kind of full circle, because the first organized team he played on back in Texas was with his dad.
And a swing and a miss. Huge strikeout there. We're at the top of the 8th, and here's the first baseman, Parker. Smith back to work.
After his teaching days, Smith was a foreman in a steel mill for a while before he became a scout for the Chicago Cubs. Another full circle moment there, since his old teammate and manager, Buck O'Neill, had been scouting for him since 1955.
Oh, he gloves it. Floyd in the box now, takes strike one. Line to right, base hit.
always feels amazing getting a job done when the team needs you to come through. It's just bigger than your own individual stats. That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you got to make them pay.
Next one misses, and that's ball one. Swing and a miss. One and two. Smith kicks and delivers. And now two and two. That misses the zone, and the count's full. And a pop-up, right side, foul territory. Drops into the glove, and there are two down.
And I know you want to be patient as a hitter, but you got to be ready to jump on the first thing straight. And he got one right there, but left the bat on his shoulder.
And a swing and a miss.
One ball, two strikes. Ball.
Well, he might have to look for a different put-away pitch right here, 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times in this at-bat, so might have it timed up and ready for it.
Struck him out looking with the off-speed stuff. Back now at Muehlbach Field. We go to the ninth, and now Adams. Smith back to work. Swings and misses. That's strike one. Swing and a miss. That's strike two. Swing and a ball popped up. And there's one away. That one's in there, 0-1. Now he breaks his bat, and O'Neill makes the play. And a couple of quick outs. Swing and a miss. 1-1. On the ground right side. Ball game. Hilton Smith with a great relief outing to seal it for KC.
It is Hilton Smith who is credited with having introduced or recommended Jackie Roosevelt Robinson to Kansas City Monarchs owner James Leslie Wilkinson. Hilton had seen Jackie playing against a white military baseball team that had major league players on it in 1942. He quickly recommended Jackie to Monarchs owner James Leslie Wilkinson. When Jackie gets discharged from the military in 1944, he writes to Monarchs owner J.O. Wilkinson, and Wilkie gives him a tryout. He makes the team, and he joins the Kansas City Monarchs in 1945. Many credit Hilton Smith for introducing us to the man that would break Major League Baseball's six-decade-long self-imposed color barriers.